adding off Dominus Sanctum Fatherum to tenth of ten a day, oh. Et Nativity Deus Sanctum Angelum tuum de Chirli. Qui gusto di F of the F chronica, visit at Aqua Defender Omnis Habitatus in Doc Capitaculo. Per Christum Dominum Nostrum.
Hallelujah. gloria in excelsis Deo.
Abundantia militiae, in mansur generatorship in sidium verba, qua potus salvare animus vestra.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et vos spiritus tuo.
Sequentia sancti evangelii secundum Johanna.
Gloria tibi, Domine.
Mm. in illo tempore, dixit Jesus discipulus suis, vade et enqui missit me, et nemo ex vobis intercat me quo vadii. Sequia henc locutus om vobis, tritsitiem plevit quo vestro, sed ege veritatem dico vobis, expedit vobis odicem vadam, si edem non ebiero, Paracletus non venit at vos, si autem ebiero mitem eam at vos, ecum venerant ille, agrep mundum de peccata, et de justitia, et de judicio, de peccata quidam, quia non crediterant in me, de justitia vera quia et patrem vade, et iam non videbis me, de judicio autem qui principes huius mundi, iam judicatus est, ad hoc modo habeo verbis dicere, sed non potus portare modo, cum autem venerit illi spiritus veritatis, docebit vos omnia veritatem, non enim loqueo ad semet ipso, sequem cumque adient loquendo, eque venture son annunciabit vobis, illi me clarificabit, quia de me excepit, et annunciabit vobis.
Notices for this, the fourth Sunday after Easter. Please take home a copy of the bulletin and please read it. You're reminded that today, 4 p.m, is the crowning of Our Lady and the Rosary, which will take place at the Grotto. 5 p.m, Holy Hour in the church. 6 p.m, Holy Mass, and 7 p.m, Supper in Hall. Please bring a flower to present to Our Lady, Mother of All. If you can't come this afternoon, just bring a flower during the month of May, the month of Our Lady, and present it to Our Lady there. Mother's Day high tea for ladies next Saturday, in conjunction with the Knights, St Martha's Cafe running a Mother's Day high tea for all the ladies of the community. Tiernan is at the back with the details. So you can get your tickets there for the high tea next Saturday, which will be preceded by a holy hour at 11 a.m. and Mass at 12 noon, low Mass. Details in the bulletin. Children's Legion of Mary, there's a Wednesday and Thursday group now. And also we want expressions of interest for St Anne's Children's Choir, whether or not you have children who are interested in music and singing. It will rehearse weekly, and as well as that, the idea is to learn music and, of course, how to sing. So it's more teaching them some skills about singing and music and learning to read music, and also, of course, to sing at Mass as well. Further details in the bulletin. Easter menu for St Martha's Cafe, now open. Donations to help the running of the cafe will be grateful to receive. And thank you for your support of the cafe. Supporting the cafe is supporting St Anne's Church, for all the monies go to support the church and the running of St Anne's. Confirmation and First Holy Communion. parents of children or other people interested in making either their first Holy Communion or confirmation, please contact myself and I will email you out the forms and the details. Date for first Holy Communion and confirmation organised for the public holiday on Monday the 7th of June. You're reminded that the Catholic is available, so if you haven't got your copy of the Catholic, see Seamus at the entrance there to get your copy of the Catholic to read. I remind you that the special Sunday sermon is emailed out each week and also available on our St. Anne's YouTube channel, and that this sermon at Sunday Mass is shorter and different to the sermon given on YouTube and the one emailed out with the bulletin. So please note that. Now the Creed of St. Athanasius begins, "Whosoever shall be saved needeth before all things to hold fast the Catholic faith, which faith, unless a man keep whole and undefiled, without doubt he will perish eternally. Now the Catholic faith is this, that we worship one God in Trinity and the Trinity in unity." And of course there are many other verses. And a priest says it in his breviary on Trinity Sunday, but for many of you are perhaps unaware of this Athanasian Creed, which is one of the official creeds of the Church, written by Saint Athanasius, whose feast day it is today. So I would suggest you go read the Athanasian Creed on this day, as it's a profession of faith and says what we must believe to be saved. Now, Saint Athanasius, as a young boy, had the honour of going out into the Egyptian desert where he met the great Saint Anthony of the desert, from whom the Franciscan Anthony of Padua received his name. Now, the early desert fathers like Anthony retreated into the silence and harshness of the desert to seek intimate union with our Lord. And then people would go out into the desert to meet their fathers, to pray with them, and receive spiritual advice. At this time, all over the deserts of Egypt were hundreds of thousands of monks and sisters, all in the desert, all praying to God and asking his blessings on the world. Now, Athanasius would go on to become a great bishop. He wrote the definitive biography of St. Anthony, detailing Anthony's holiness and his struggles with temptation. Anthony would confront the devil. The devil would afflict St. Anthony with terrible temptations, and when he resisted these, the devil would wage war upon him by sending visions of wild beasts, scorpions, snakes, wolves, and lions. And St. Anthony lived mostly in seclusion as a hermit in the desert. But in 338 AD, he left the desert to travel to Alexandria to help refute the teachings of Arius. Although not particularly learned, he was able to confound the Arians and help St. Athanasius, who was bishop there. Now, like the Desert Father St. Anthony, Athanasius was a man of great holiness who stood up against the error of Arius. Athanasius faced hostile attacks, not only of the devil, but also his brother bishops, priests, judges, magistrates, emperors, and other intellectuals had fallen into this error. Bishop Athanasius was exiled from his diocese by Arian heretics five times, spending 17 years of his life in exile from Alexandria. Yet from exile, he continued to write against this heresy and teach the true faith. He is known in church history as a hammer of heretics. Now, what was the Arian heresy? It claimed that Jesus was the greatest man to live, but the title Son of God could only be applied to him in the same way that it applied to the great men of the Old Testament, or anyone who seeks to will do the will of God. So in short, the Arians, of course, denied the divinity of Christ, that Jesus was truly God and consubstantial with the Father. Though this heresy was quickly condemned by the Patriarch of Alexandria in the Council of Nicaea in 325 AD, Arianism spread like wildflower, especially amongst men of power, including the emperor. Now, as Bishop of Alexandria, Athanasius stridently defended the doctrine of our Lord's divinity. But many priests, bishops, sided with the emperor, who played a much larger role in the church politics than any world leader today, and of course, exiled Athanasius. Now imagine if all the bishops of a country fell into heresy and only one remained faithful. One might say it's happening in certain countries today. It happened to Saint Athanasius in Egypt. It happened in England when John Fisher was the only one who stood against Henry VIII. And it could happen again, where we have bishops and priests aligning with worldly philosophies instead of the truth of Christ. I don't have to give you any examples of bishops and priests doing this. You can just read the daily paper to find bishops agreeing with the worldly philosophy. Now, there seems to be times when we are standing alone in preaching the Catholic faith. But we must remember we are never truly alone. For when we stand up for the truth, we are always in communion with the great fathers of the church. We're in communion with the apostles and with the Lord himself, who called himself the truth. I am the way, the truth, and the life. And our Lord can neither deceive us nor be deceived. In fact, St. Athanasius, during one of his exiles, said, "They may have all the churches, but we have the holy faith." So in one sense, one never loses the church if one stays in line with the truth of Christ. So commitment to Christ means commitment to truth, and that's what all our confirmees will have to do. Commit to Christ, commit to the truth of our faith. As we know, we live in an age of great cultural relativism and great moral error. So our world needs the truth of Christ preached clearly, consistently, and courageously. May we, like the great Saint Athanasius, have the fortitude and the perseverance to defend the true faith, the faith of our fathers, without counting the cost, for the glory of God and for the salvation of souls. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Thank you.
Omnia secula seculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritus tuum.
Sursum corda. Sergamus Domino Deo Nostro.
Dignum et Deus
dignum et justum est, decum et salutare, de quidem Domini omni tempore, sed in hoc potissimum gloriosus predicare, cum Pascha nostrum immolatus est Christus, ipse enim verus est omnius, quia absolut peccata mundi, qui mortem nostrum aende destruxit, et vitam miserendo reparavit, et idio cum angelis ec arcangelus, cum tonus ad dominatio onibus, conque omnibus estis exercitus, in nom gloriae tue canimus, sine fine decente.
Thank you.
Nobis quaeque peccatoribus. Omnia secula seculorum. Oremus bishoptis solitaribus moniti et divina institutione formati audemus dicere Pater noster qui es in celis sanctificetur nomen tuum Adveniat regnum tuum, via voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem.
Sicut nos
Omnia secula seculorum. Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Miserata vesti omnipens Deus, et misericordiatis vestis, dignus vos et vivum in eterno. Et et se matrix in unitium in peccatorum et strong people verbis somnipens misericordia. Etch in us de etch et catholus et catholus et catholus. Domine in omnis in dignus et dignus et dignus et commands et times verbis of the anime. Domine in omnis in dignus et dignus et dignus et commands et times verbis of the anime. Domine in omnis in dignus et 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 dignus
debitus sum simus, et perce mora feturus, et apertus omnes eru amo. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui te convivit regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobis.
Sancti Vangelii secundum Johannem. In principe verbum, verbum potem, et Deus autem in principe potem. Omnipotens factus omnes, in esse factum est, ne esse factum est, in esse vitae et vitae lux omnes. Et lux intensus vitaeis et mene comprehenduit. Qui in omnes missal te, cum in omnes ratio hans, et manum testimonium, testimonium peraita lumina. Nomus cotae per lumina. Non ever lux testimonium peraita lumina, ever lux fere quae luminos omnem hominem in illum quinda. In monitor ad, munus of actus es, munus ad, no cook no evit, in propter vanit, or so mayam non shepherd. Crocodum shepherd and edit as first time of videos dear fury. As criminally as green non ex and gredes nequeus, fun and canis nequeus, fun and tade fury. Sed ex day, non du so. A fathom chiropractum as, the capital of it in nervous. A vidimus grey as crocus, the engineer patre. Penium gratiae, et verum.